Good afternoon. Let's try that again. Good afternoon. Well, welcome to the 2017 Hitchcock-Tulare Homecoming Pep Rally. We've got a lot of things planned today, but Mother Nature had a different agenda, I guess. So we're going to do our very best to stick with our schedule we had planned, and that starts with our Pep Rally right now. So starting off with this, there's a lot of thank yous that have to go out. We often forget to thank the people that make this possible each and every year. So first off, I want to give a thank you to Mr. Barry. He has diligently worked to get our football field up to at least game performance tonight with the weather this summer and a thing called a grub. Is done wonders for our field, so but it looks fabulous. He's put a lot of time into that. So thank you, Mr. Barry, for at least having our field looking good for a nice game. Also, we need to thank Ms. Copeland. She is our student council advisor. She does a phenomenal job with the student council. And part of her leadership has created a very strong student council here at Hitchcock-Tulare. And the student council this year, I think, did an outstanding job of picking a theme, dress-up days. Pretty much this whole week, I think, is one of the best weeks I've seen in homecoming. And so congratulations, Ms. Copeland and the student council. You guys did a great job this week. The most importantly, that we have got today are the parents, the guardians, the grandparents, the brothers, the sisters, who make dress-up day possible. I know as a parent myself, you always get hit with, I need this for tomorrow, and it's 10 o'clock. So the parents and the families that have supported your kids and participated and have got them involved in the dress-up day, I would say, guessing 95% of our students dressed up all week long. And so that shows a lot of school spirit. It shows exactly patriot pride that we've been preaching here at the school. So go off of that. Talk a little about Homecoming Week. Most of you know our theme this year was board games. And I thought that was a very clever topic for this year. Everybody likes games, and the variety of games out there makes for a pretty enjoyable week. So as you know, on Monday we did Dressed Like a Celebrity, and you can really see the age difference for us older people and the kids, because you know, our celebrities of our time and theirs are, well, you know, Taylor Swift, and you have no idea who they are, but once you look at them, you're like, you are Taylor Swift, good job. So that was on Monday. Tuesday, we did Injury Day. Our theme was, I believe, sorry, right? Our operation, whatever it was. So we had to dress up if we're injured or hurt, and I think everybody did a phenomenal job doing that. That night, we had Grove Volleyball, and ladies who play volleyball, you have my respect. It is a tough game. It is, and apparently I hit it long every time. I guess you can't hit it underhand or with your knee or anything else, but that was a good game. Mr. Salmon's team was the Grove Ball Championships this year. I'd like to thank Mr. Godfrey. He donated the car for our car lash, which was right back here. That's such a stress-relieving thing, I can't tell you how much fun that is. You know, you just swing for all you got, and that car has seen better days now. So thank you, Mr. Godfrey, for donating that car. I appreciate that. Wednesday was a class color day, so each grade had a color. And I think we about had 100% turnout on that, so that was a good day for dress up. Thursday was Dress Your Best Day, so we wanted you to, the theme was Monopoly. We wanted you to look your absolute best on that, and we had FFA that day and some other things going on, so we didn't get as high a turnout, but it was real good what we had. And then that afternoon, we had an ice cream bar, and I've always learned two things in life motivate people, money and food, and yeah, I did. It was a great experience, and you know, ice cream is amazing. So that was a good day. So on our today, Friday, we got a pep rally now. We got the parade to follow. We got a bunch of other things going on. And we'll address those shortly. So to start off our activities every year, the student body votes for homecoming king and queen. Okay. So this year's 2017 homecoming queen is Miss Allie Mayer.
Thank you.
Zach's future is as a motivational speaker, so it's a good start. So next thing we're going to do here is, homecoming involves is, I think a lot of people get this conception that it's just for football. It's not, it's for all sports. So the first thing I'd like to do is introduce our sports teams that are currently in season. So Mrs. McNeil, please come forward and introduce your cross-country team.
A lot of people on there. We played Tarrant County at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And then next week we go to Iroquois, and then next Thursday we have our big pink night in Hitchcock, so we're asking everybody to come out for that. And then kind of the highlight of our year, the last couple of years, we go down to the Sanford Pentagon and play down there. And we've drawn Copenhagen and good Hanson team, which Hanson's like 7-0 right now, so we're going to have to work that out for us, but I think the girls are up to the challenge. So the girls love playing in front of a large crowd, so we'd like to see a lot more people at our match, and they play better when we have a loud crowd, and they'll give you a good show. They're going to get better as we go. Thank you.
Okay, we're going to do our own little skit. Well, it's not a skit, we call it football, but boys, we're going to line up here, we're going to play for you. As you know, tonight we play Falkton on our homecoming. Falkton's a good football team, and I honestly feel we are 100% better. So we need all of your support tonight to come out, regardless of the weather. We really need you to be here tonight. We need your support. This is a huge game for our football program. It's a huge statement win. And I'll come back and address that in just a second. Most of us know last year we had a rough year. We didn't win a game. And that's a humbling experience for anybody to go through. And these guys came out this year and said, that's going to stop. And we are currently sitting at 2-2, and our next four games are all winnable. And that starts tonight with Fulton. And with that being said, our goal is to make the playoffs, because that's where Hitchcock-Tulare Patriots belong, is in the playoffs. So we are going to do everything in our power the next four games to make sure that we get to play Monday night in the fall in the playoffs against whoever we draw. And we will give you everything we possibly can to make you proud, and hopefully in the end we come out successful. So I appreciate all you guys' effort and hard work. You're a great group of guys. I couldn't ask for a better team.
We would like to thank our coaching staff, because without them, we wouldn't be where we are right now. They spend countless hours after our games to break down the film, and then they send it out to us. So we have access to film 100% of the time all the time. And we'd like to thank our junior high boys and girls who don't always get in, because even when you're not in, you're still impacting us on the field and cheering and getting us hyped up. So thank you guys, and hope to see you guys out at the game tonight. Thank you.
I think there's a couple people that I want to save for last, because, you know, you save the best for last. First I need to thank our cheerleaders who come out every week, and they cheer us on. They're on the sidelines giving us their support. So ladies, thank you very much for your commitment to our team. So I think there's a group here that we're saving for last, because I have seven young ladies that volunteered their time to be managers. I have three statisticians, three senior girls, Bailey Cole, Allie Boehner, and Bailey Yander. She'll come down to be recognized. And I really like these three young ladies. They're a great group to be around. And I really like reading their stats, because last year, everyone on the team, according to Bailey Cole, had at least 70 tackles a game. So that was good. That was good. And there were a couple kids that didn't even play, and they had 70 tackles. So that was even better. And I got four managers that do all the side work that makes our games possible every Friday night. So both Sydney Maynard and Dan Peterson and Cassie Johnson and Teddy, and please come down here. These young ladies do a great job making sure these guys are hydrated, except we don't have that tonight. Those water bottles are where? Sully Beach. So so I'm thankful it's not hot. Hopefully we get a little rain so they can stand here and do this. But in seriousness, thank you a lot for our team. And, I think the funny thing is we do have one young man on this team that I've never seen a human sweat quite like him. Like, it's like a death sweat. And that's Caleb. He is soaking wet before he puts his pants on. And I just look at the faces of these girls, and they just look at him like they're absolutely appalled, which is just fine. But it's just funny to see that, you know, these ladies are as integral part of our team as every one of those boys all the way up. And so thank you, all of you, for everything you do for the Patriot program. Thank you. Okay, next up, we have the whole point of Pep Rally here is to have some fun. So, ladies, the floor is yours.
So for first aid, we need the Thank you. I'll put it in like slow motion and put it on YouTube and Facebook and.
I'm calling it 5 million views next week. All right, thanks for everyone that participated. The girls have put in a lot of hard work to get this ready for you today. I just want to introduce them, and then they're going to show you what we've been working on the past couple of weeks. We practice every day for a couple of hours, so they put a lot of time into this. But the cheerleaders that I have this year are a great group of girls. I don't lose anybody next year if they want to come back and cheer for me. I'll start on the outside. Danielle Wright.
Thanks again for coming and joining in the festivities today. Have a great day.